case V1 to V4 or V5 the same deep symmetrical T wave inversions are there, those will be considered as differential dynamics of Wellens syndrome. So primarily we will be discussing permeable embolism, RVP and RVH we know of, we discussed LVH will be there, HOCM is one of the important differential dynamics, raised intracranial pressure, normal pediatric ECG, persistent juvenile T wave pattern and Brugada syndrome, all this can be considered as differential diagnosis of Wellens syndrome. So here we are at the first thing we are going to be considering one of the differential diagnosis, that is there is a massive pulmonary embolism. How will you know? There is slight tachycardia is there, okay, and then the patient is having a deep Q waves, or in turn there may, if you consider it as a small R is there, it is actually RSR pattern with strain pattern is there. And as you can consider why we are considering it as the differential diagnosis of Wellens syndrome, because here is the T wave inversion in V1, V2, almost up to V3. And when you are considering with the strain pattern, tachycardia is there, AVR elevation is there, very important. And then there is slight changes in the 2-3 AVF also. But after that, if you consider there is a huge, like because it is a acute pulmonary embolism, there is acute hypokinesia of the RV wall. So like the ECG changes are more regarding that one, like RV has become dilated and it is compressing LV, and the LV amplitudes are really getting very less and very less and very less. You can see that there is a huge decrease in the progression of R wave, there is reciprocal reversal of the progression of R wave, all the voltages are very much less. If the acute episode is considered and the patient's condition is considered, if it is quite easy to consider that the patient is having a pulmonary embolism. Most of the ECGs will be having slight modified variants of S1, Q3, T3 syndrome. You can see that there is a slight TPS when compared to the R, and also there is a small Q when compared to the prominent R should be seen in the, because inferior axis is not there. So there is a Q and there is a T wave inversion in the the lead 3, S1, Q3, T3. This is a minor variant of the S1, Q3, T3, but obviously when considered in, taken in all consideration, RVV strain pattern, tachycardia and low voltage complexes, poor progression of R waves and a S1, Q3, T3 pattern, you should be considered that it is a pulmonary embolism. So here also similar thing, the RVBB is there, first degree AV block is there, there is a deep Q and T wave inversion. You can consistently see that this pattern is S1, Q3, T3 can be seen very, very bright in this ECG. You can see that there is a deep S in the lead 1, there is a deep Q in lead 3 and a deep T wave inversion in lead 3. So S1, Q3 pattern, T3 pattern for the beginners is something like this. You can absolutely consider it as a pulmonary embolism, a big RVBB, a very good strain pattern, there is proved progression of RV, a deep S in the lateral leads, and there is a huge S1, Q3, T3 pattern.